type of session where other students. So let's wait for 5 minutes. So now next type of session. Today's topic is what are the various thread methods. In the last class we have discussed about what are the threads, what are the various stages of the thread, that is the life cycle of a thread, and what are the various we can say how to create a thread by using the runnable executable by using the thread class. So let's move to the next topic, that is thread methods. What are the various thread methods that is used in, what are the various thread function that is used in the multitasking or multi-programming. So following is a list of the important methods available in the thread class. So first one is a void start, that is public void start. So this starts a thread in a separate path of execution that involves a run method. It's the responsibility of the invoke method or the responsibility of the thread that invokes the thread run method on this thread object. That is a public void start. So this starts a thread in a separate path of execution, then invokes the run method on this thread object. Then public void run. So if this thread object initialized using a separate runnable target, the run method is used or the run method is applicable for or run method is applicable for the for differentiation on the term for differentiation on that runnable object, that is public void run. Then next one is public final void set name. So if I want to set the name, so if I want to change the name of the thread object, suppose I have created one thread object, I want to change the name afterwards, that is later on. So that is, that name will be changed by using the public final void set name string name. There is also a get name function or method for retrieving the name. So we are using the getName method or the thread object for using the string name or using the setName. Then public final void set property int property. This sets the property of this thread object and the possible values are between 1 and 10. So we are setting the properties of the thread, that is which thread will become first, then second, then third, and so on. And it ranges from the 0 to the 1. And the possible values range from 0 to 10. And if I say that there is a normal property or the normal possible value, that is a 5. The next one is public final void set daemon boolean on. So it means a parameter of the view that denotes this thread as a daemon thread. So daemon thread means a dummy thread that is used as set as a daemon. Then public final void join long millisecond. So this is the current thread invokes this method on a second thread that causes the current thread to blow until the second thread terminates. That means if the first thread is over, then moves to the second thread. If that is also terminated, then yes, this will cause an error. Now listen, this method is used for a second thread that causes the current thread to blow until the second thread terminates. So until and unless next thread is not moving around or not getting around, so it will not execute. It will terminate at that point. Then public void interrupt. This interrupts this thread, causing it to continue execution if it was not blocked by for any reason. So if it is blocked by any reason, there is a wastage of the energy of the CPU. There is a wastage of the resources available by the OS. So it's better to terminate that thread and again rejoin that thread or again rejoin the or create the thread again and again and then move to the new part. This interrupt this thread, causing it to the continue execution if it is blocked for any reason. Then public final boolean is alive. So this returns us to you if the thread is alive or not, which is any time after the thread has been starting or started out before it runs to the completion. So this means we are checking if the thread is alive or not. So we can check at any time and it is gives a value either in the 2 or the 4 because we are using the boolean data type. So this is returns to you if the thread is alive, which is any time after the thread has been started but before it runs to completion. So these are the 7 important methods of the thread. So one is for the starting purpose. So it executes a thread by using the start. That means if the first stage of the thread, then run. For the execution of the thread, we are using the public void run method. Then public final void set name. So for giving the name of the thread or name to the thread, so we are using the public for the public final void set name string name. Then void or public final void set property or priority. So we are setting the priority which thread come first, then which thread. That is also a function and that also ranges from the 0 to the 10. The next one is public final void set daemon. So we are also setting the daemon. We are also using the daemon for the parameters that is used as a daemon thread. The next one is public final void thread. So the current thread can invoke this method on a second thread. That means if the one method is or one thread is going on, so it is possible to join or terminate the second thread on a specified number of the millisecond that is passed. Then a public void interrupt. So this interrupt is thread causing it to the continue execution if it is a block by any reason. Then public final boolean is alive. So this returns that thread or this returns the true if the thread is alive or not, which is any time after the thread has been started but before it turns to the completion. So the previous methods are invoked on a particular thread object, and this method or the following method in the class are static. Invoking one of the setting method performs the operation on the currently running. So next method is public static void yield. So this causes the currently running thread to yield to other threads of the same priority that are waiting to be scheduled. So if you are waiting to be scheduled on a method, if you are waiting to be scheduled on a specified term, so we are going to yield on the other thread of the same priority that are willing to be scheduled. Then public static void sleep long milliseconds. So this causes the currently running thread to glow for at least the specified number of milliseconds. So that means it is invoking or it is going to glow for at least, or glow means it is going to hold or glow for at least a specified number of the milliseconds. Then public static boolean holds low. So it holds a low, that means if the current thread holds a low coming given object or not. This is also the boolean value. This is also the boolean category that gives the output in a true or the false. Then public static thread, current thread. This returns a reference to the currently running thread, which is the thread that invokes this method. In the last case, it is returning the values. In this case, it is returning the reference that is a Then public static void dump stack. So this brings a stack trace for the currently running thread, which is useful when debugging a multi-thread application. So it is a multi-threaded application. It is easy to debug the thread. It is easy to debug the currently running thread that is done by the public static void dump stack. So these are the five methods. These are the eight methods. So these 8 + 5, that is 13 methods, are used for creating a thread, for running the thread, for joining the thread, for interrupting, for setting the LI, whatever the term that is used by using the threads, that is done by these 13 methods, the 13 functions that are used in the thread. Now, this is an example. So the following thread class demo program demonstrates some of these methods of the thread class. Some of the method that is used with the thread class. So consider a case that is a case display message which implements an enable. So, one of the class name is a display message that implements an enable class that is used with the enable class. So one is a file name. Name of the file is display message or Java. The next one is create a thread to implement the enable. So creating a thread to implement the enable class. This is public class display message implements enable. So name of the class is the display message, and this implements our enable class or the enable term. So one of the class name is display message, and that implements our enable part. Then public class display message implements enable. So private string message. So it is using as a private function. It is using as a private part string message. Then public display message string message. So in the private category, it is used as a string message or the private part. The next one is public display message string message. So display message is the name of the function, and it is using the string message. It is using the message of the string type. Then this dot message equals to message. So this dot message means it is using the dot operator with this, that message value is stored in the this dot message. Then public void run. So while it is true, system.out.println message. So this is printing on the screen whatever the output or whatever the data that is available in the message. So this prints the output of the variable message. until it is true. So one of the file name is the display message.java. Name of the class is display message that implements the runnable class. And there is a private string message, public display message, string message. Then this dot message equals to message. Then public void run. While it is true, then system.out.println for printing on the screen. Message value will be printed. It is a system.out.println message. Then this is the closing of this while loop. This is the closing of this void run, and this is the closing of this public class display message. Now this is another class that extends the thread class. One is the runnable class that use the runnable method. Next one is using the extend keyword, using the extend keyword for making the thread, for making the or removing the or for joining the thread. This is again the same class that is the guest number that extends the thread. Then private int number, it is taking off the int category of the private part, and number is the variable. Then public guest number int number. The guest number is again the name of the function, and the argument is the int number. Then this dot number equals to number. So this dot number equals to number means number value will be stored in the this dot number for this dot number variable. And public or public void run int counter equals to 0. Then int guess equals to 0. So counter equals to 0 is a variable. So counter variable has a value 0. And then guess equals to 0, guess have a value 0. Then using the do loop, do guess equals to int, then math.random into star plus or into 100 plus 1. So guess is the name of the variable that is stored, that stores the value of the int category using the random function. So math.random is using the random function into 100 plus 1. So whatever the random value, it is taken from the math, that is multiplied by the 100 and addition of the 1. Then system.out.println this dot get name. It is using the this dot get name for using the values. Then guesses, then plus guess. So this is system.out.println this dot get name, then plus guesses, and then there is a guess variable. Then counter plus plus. So it will increment each and every time whenever it is going to loop, whenever it is going to execute the loop. So counter plus plus. Then using the while loop, while guess is not equals to number. So this will run or this will execute until the guess value is not equals to number. So if it is not equals to number, it will terminate the loop, or it will execute the loop. But it will if equals to number, it will terminate the loop. And this is a do while loop. So it will execute at least one time. The reason is that in the do while, the condition is checked at the end. So it is executing at least one time. So while guess is not equals to number, then system.out.println correct this dot get name, then int counter, then guess, then star star star. So one is a star star correct, then this dot get name. So using the dot operator, it is taking from the this variable, this dot get name, then in, it is printed as it is, in, then next one is counter, that is the counter value will be printed over here, then there is a guesses will print as it is, and there is a full stop also, and there are two stars after the dot, after the full stop. This will print, this one is same, then print the value of the get name, then next one is as it is, then prints the value of the variable counter, then it will print as it is, that is the guesses, then dot, star, star, then after this there is a closing of the curly braces, and after this there is a semicolon for termination of the line. Then this is the closing of this void run, and this is the closing of this class guess number. Right. So first class is guess number that extends a thread, then private int number, then guess number, int number, then this dot number equals to number, void run. taking two variable, counter equals to 0, guess equals to 0, then guess equals to int, math.random into 100 plus 1, then system.out.println, this.getName, plus guesses, plus guess, then counter plus plus. While guess is not equals to number, then system.out.println, correct, this.getName, then counter, then guesses. This is output. File name is printed as it is because it is available within the comments. So this is print as it is, file name thread class demo.java. Then this is not the output. This is the main program which makes use of the defined class. Yes. This is the output over here. Right. So this is the main class that is represented over here. So this is the main program that makes use of the above the defined classes. So file name is thread class demo.java. Then public class, thread class name or thread class demo, public static void main string args. We are using the main function over here. So public static void main string args. Now, this look carefully. We are creating one object of the runnable type, runnable hello equals to new display message. So we are taking as a class or we are taking as an object as a hello that is equal to the new display message. And what is the content in this one? What is the argument in this one? That is a hello. Then thread one. It is taking the thread one as a variable of thread type that is equals to the new thread hello. Again, it is using the new as a or getting the new thread, and it is showing or it is taking the argument as a hello. Then thread one dot set daemon true. So it is taken out as a thread one dot set daemon true or set daemon equals to true or set daemon true. So value of the set daemon is true. Then thread one dot set name. Now this is set daemon. That means daemon or the process will be turn out to be true. Then set name hello. That means we are taking the thread name. We are assigning the thread name as a hello. So that's why it is given within the bracket and within the double quotes hello. Then system.out.println for printing on the screen. Starting hello thread. So it is showing the output as it is on the screen. What is the output? Starting hello thread. Then thread one dot start. So one is first of all assigning the process, that is set demo, then assigning the name. After this, writing on the screen, starting the hello thread. Then next part, or we can say the next step is the thread one dot start. Then runnable by means by is the name of the variable that is of the runnable type. Then equals to the new display message goodbye. So it is display on the screen new display message goodbye. Then thread 2, now it is again taking the variable as a thread 2, that is of a thread type, equals to the new thread by. So look, it is showing for the hello, it is showing for the goodbye, it is creating the new thread, that is a by. Then thread 2 dot set priority, so it is using as a set priority for the thread dot minimum priority. It is taking the minimum priority as a, what is the minimum priority? That is the minimum priority is a 1. Then thread 2 dot set daemon true. Then system.out.println starting goodbye thread. So we are starting at the from the goodbye thread. System.out.println starting goodbye thread. Thread 2 dot start. It is taken out at the thread 2 dot start value or start function. Then system.out.println starting thread 3. So it is taking at the, or this is displaying the starting of the thread 3. This is a hello thread, starting of hello thread. This is a starting of the goodbye thread. This is the last thread, that is a thread. That is a thread 3. This is thread 1 dot start, thread 2 dot start, and next one is thread 3 dot start. After this, there is a try block. Within the try block, it is joining or it is used to join the third thread with the above thread, that is the goodbye and the hello thread. This is taken out as a thread 3 dot join, then catch interpret exception E. Interpret exception E has a variable E, small e. System.out.println thread interrupted. So in this the thread is interrupted. So it is showing on the screen that the thread is interrupted by using the system.out.println. Again, it is showing for the system.out.println starting the thread 4. So till thread 3, it is printed that the thread is interrupted for a moment. The next one is starting the thread number 4. Then thread 4. So it is a variable name is the thread 4 of the thread type. Equals to the new guess a number. So guess a number is a value We are assigning the value as 75 that is stored in the guesser number 75 of the new type that is stored in the thread number 4. So thread 4 is the category of the thread type that is equal to the new guesser number 75. Then thread 4 dot start. So thread 4 dot start means it is using the start function. Then thread 4 dot start. System dot out dot println main is ending. So in this it is written as main is ending over here. Then there is a closing of the curly braces over here of this void main function, and this is the closing of the main class. So in this there are four threads that is taken out. One is a goodbye thread, one is a hello thread, one is a thread number 3, one is a thread number 4. And the thread number, after thread number 3, it is showing for the try block. Within the try block, it is used for the thread 3 dot join. Then catch the exception. Then system dot out dot println, that is a thread interrupted. After the thread interrupted, we are starting with the thread number 4. We are assigning the value of the new guest number. What is the guest number? That is 75. We are taking as a guest number of the thread 4. Then thread 4 dot start. Again, using the start with the or start function with the thread number 4. Then system.out.println main is ending. Now the main is, or the main function is ending over here. So it is showing on the screen that the main is ending. So this would produce, or this will produce the following result. You can try this example again and again until and unless, or that you get the result every time. There is a different result. The main reason is that it is using the thread, it is using the hello thread, it is using the goodbye thread. So it depends on the value to value. So every time it gives the output as a different, or as a different output. So starting hello thread, starting goodbye thread. This is the starting of the hello thread, this is the starting of the goodbye thread. This is the first part, goodbye and the hello thread. Then there are four or five hellos. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five hellos are available, then there is a goodbye because we are giving the start function with this one. Then goodbye, after goodbye there is a dot 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 for goodbye concepts. So read out this program, these two program basically, that is combined program. So and yes, these two are related with the extend class, these two are combined with the extend class. And if there is any doubt, then please clear the doubts. So that we can move to the next topic, that is a different topic, but are the various concepts that is used in the Java multi-threading. So let's start with this program after 5 minutes. So take out 5 minutes for reading this program. So let's move to the next topic, next part. That is a major Java multi-threading concept. So what are the various concepts? That is a major part. Major part means that will be implemented or that will be useful in implementing the Java programming. That is a major Java multi-threading concept. A multi-threading concept. So while doing the multi-threading programming in Java, you will need to have the following concepts that is used with the, or you need to have a following concepts very handy. Handy means you are very efficient with these concepts. You are very used to with these concepts already. It is used in the programming in the Java. First one is, what is thread synchronization? Synchronization means there is a coordination between the client and the server, the thing or the thread synchronization. So we can say the coordination, communication between the client and the server. Next one is handling the threads intercommunication. How to handle the threads within the intercommunication means within the local system, within the local rule, how to handle the threads, that the handling threads intercommunication. After this, there is a handling thread deadlock. So if there is a deadlock that is arrived, deadlock is a condition when neither go forward, never go beyond. That is a deadlock. So how to handle the threads that are in a deadlock condition? That major thread operations. What are the various major thread operations? What are the various major thread calculations that will be done in the multi-threading? So let's start with the first one. That is, what is the thread synchronization? So when we start with the two or more threads within a program, there may be a condition when the multiple threads try to access the same resource. So this is the requirement that we have discussed, that if the two resources or if the same or the two threads or multiple threads try to access the same threads, same resource, and finally they can produce unforeseen result due to the concurrency issue. So due to the high load over the OS, so that leads to the concurrency issue because that is not available with the one other thread. For example, if multiple threads try to write or try to write within the same file, they may corrupt the data because one of the threads can override the data or while other thread is opening the same value at the same time. That means it is not able to write on the file by two threads at the same time. Because if one thread is opening the file, another thread or another thread work is lost up. So by one thread is opening the file at the same time, another thread might be closing the same file. So it depends on the file to file, it depends on the property to property or the priority to priority. So there is a need to synchronize the data. Need for synchronize the data means so there is a need or requirement to synchronize the action of multiple threads and make sure that only one thread will arrive at the same time. There is no host port, there is no, we can say the one overrides with the other, no. But that should maintain in a queue. So there is a need to synchronize the action of multiple threads and make sure that only one thread can access the resource at a given point of time. So at the same time or at one time, it is going to access only one resource at the same time. So one thread can access the resource at a given point in time. This is implemented by using the concept known as the monitor. So it is using, or this is implementing, or this concept that is only one thread is using at the same time. So this concept is implemented using the monitor. And each object in a Java is associated with the monitor. So each and every thread object, that may be a thread object, that may be a normal object, is associated, means is involved with the monitor. Monitor, that is a device that is used that makes sure that only one thread can access the resource at the same time. So each and every object is associated with the monitor. Which a thread can loop or unloop. So it's a object category that is associated with monitor, and it's a thread decision while it is unloop or locking the system. And only one thread at a time may hold a loop on a monitor. So only one thread at a time can lock a monitor, can use a monitor, or may hold to lock a monitor on the screen. Java programming language provides a very handy way of creating the threads and synchronizing their tasks by using the synchronized blocks. So it is using the synchronized blocks for creating the threads and synchronize their tasks. You keep shared resources within this block, and this is a general form of the synchronized element. So the general form means the syntax of the synchronized element. This is a synchronized object identifier. Then access shared variable and other shared resources. Here the object identifier is a reference to an object whose loop associates with the monitor. That means object identifier is a reference, that is given over here, that is available to an object whose loop associated with the monitor. Each and every loop is associated with the monitor that the synchronized statement represents. Now we are going to see two examples where we will print a counter using two different concepts. So if there are two different concepts that is used, so we are using or we will print a counter using two different threads. And when threads are not synchronized, so if there is a provision not to synchronize the threads, they print a counter value which is not in a sequence. But when we print counter by using the synchronized value, synchronized flow, it will print the counter very much in sequence. Counter means a counter value that will be presented in the sequence one after the another for both the threads. So it will print the counter very much in the sequence for both the thread that is available for the synchronization. So that if the counter is one thread is using the, if another counter is decremented, that means another thread is implementing the value. So next thread will have to wait for some time until the previous thread has finished the work. So this is like a token in the token ring. So that means a token is available to the process. So until and unless your token is not arrived, you are not coming out. In the same way, object identifier is available with the each and every thread. If that identifier will be used, if that identifier will be presentable or we are going to run the object identifier that it is a reference to the object. That means it is a unique value to the thread. So when threads are not synchronized, they will print the counter values which is not in the sequence, and when they print the counter values, it will print the counter very much in sequence. Now, next is multi-threading example without synchronization. So this is with the synchronization. Next one is without synchronization. This is a simple example that may or may not print the counter value in sequence, and every time we run it, it produces a different result based on the CPU availability. So in the thread examples, the output will vary from the program to program or execution to execution because it depends on the CPU availability, it depends on the OS availability, and every system have a different CPU availability. Every system, every client and server architecture, every process have a different synchronization part, have a different part, having a different CPU availability, having a different OS availability. This is a simple program which may or may not print the counter value in a sequence, and every time we run it, it produces a different result based on the CPU. So it produces a different result based on the CPU availability to the thread. So this is a class of a print demo. Then public void print count. So this is the public void print count function. Then within the print count function, there is a try block. Within the try block, it starts with a 5, then go till 1. So it's go for the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So it is given as a condition I is greater than 0. It is not given as I is greater than equals to 0. It will go till 1. Then I minus minus, it will decrement each and every time. 5 becomes 4, 4 becomes 3, 3 becomes 2, and then at last 1. Then system.out.println counter then plus I. So it will print the counter value as a in the variable or by using the variable that is I. Then catch exception E, then system.out.println thread interrupt. So thread is interrupted over here. So system.out.println, then thread interrupted. After this, there is a try block is finished. Next try block is finished. Next main classes. This is a print demo class. Now next demo class or the next class is the thread demo that extends the thread. So it is creating the threads by using the extends keyword. So class thread demo extends thread. Then private thread T, it is taken as a private part of the private as a thread that is of the variable T. Then private string thread name. So private string thread name means it is using as a thread or it is using as a thread name of the string type. Then print demo D, PD. So it is using as a print demo as a variable of the PD. Then thread demo string name print demo PD. There are two variables, one is a name, one is a PD. The name is of the string type, PD of the print demo type. Then thread name equals to name, PD equals to small PD. So out variable is, or this PD value is stored in the variable PD. Then print void run, there's a run program. Then PD dot print count. Then system dot out dot println thread. Then there's a thread name. Then there is exiting. So first available as a thread, then the thread name or thread name value that is stored as a name, then exit. After this, there is a start function. So one is a run function, one is a start function. Starting means a starting of the thread. In this, it is available as a system.out.println starting, and then there is a thread name. So within the starting, our starting is printed as it is, then there is a thread name. Now it is checking for the condition if t is equals to null. So if the t is equals to null, then t equals to new thread, this thread name. So if it is equals to new thread, then this and the thread name, then t dot start. Next one is the start function that is taken out at the as a start. So t dot start. Then closing of curly braces of the if, this is the closing of the main class, and next one is closing of the main thread demo class. Next class is test thread. So thread demo is over. Next is the thread test thread. It is using the main function public static void main. Again, we are using the PD as a variable that stores the print demo output. For the return type of the print demo function is stored in the PD variable. Then thread demo T1. So taken out as a T1 equals to the new thread demo, thread minus 1 PD. Then thread demo T2, that is equals to the new thread demo thread 2 PD. Then T1 dot start, then T2 dot start. So one function is a T1 dot start, next function is a T2 dot start. Thread demo T1, that is new thread demo thread minus 1 PD. Then new thread demo thread minus 2 PD. Then T1 dot start and T2 dot start. And then waits for the thread to end. So that waits for the thread to the end for the place. Then there's a trap log. Within the trap log, it is used as a T1 dot join, then T2 dot join. After the trap log, it is using as a catch exception E, then system dot out dot println and